to ear, joy and jubilation etched across her countenance tonight. And the Mercury will have the game's first possession. Here's Jefferson working against Canada. Grinder with the first touch of the basketball game. Back to the corner, and the jumper is good. Oh, by the way, that's the Hall of Famer to be, Diana Taurasi. Over to Grinder with the elbow jump shot, and she rattles down her first field goal attempt. Clarendon guarded by Taurasi. Inside on the roll, and looked like it was partially blocked by Grinder, now running the floor. And it comes out to Taurasi. Taurasi went through a summer of arduous work to have one of her best seasons inside off the feed. Grinder with four quick points. One of the better players in this league with that hit-ahead pass. 9-0 lead early. Inside, and there's the first bucket by Neko Gumike. That,
of course, one of the things with Brittany Griner right now is her body is not the same as it was before she spent nearly 300 days in a prison cell. And you'll take the losing your footing to get the backwards somersault in. There's style points there.
Yeah, that needs to show up on the box score. There's Brown from downtown, knocks down the three. Breezy with the rebound. Turner with the outlet up to Jefferson. Looking to push tempo. Taurasi on a rush. Took the contact and converted. Mercury jumping out to a quick lead. They're up 14-7. Taurasi had 7 in a row a moment ago. And that bucket falls. Brittany Griner, a great moment during shoot-around. She came over and spoke with us and spent a few minutes with us and thanked us for keeping her name out there during the time that she was detained in Russia.
One of the things that was so remarkable to me was watching her first press conference about a month ago and laughing and joking and talking about this unthinkable time. Nice move there by Sissoko. The lightness about Brittany Griner is one of the things that her teammates and everyone around the league certainly missed.
Her team up by 11. Brown with a baseline drive off glass. Lexi Brown with a couple of field goals now. She's got 5. Took Sutton losing the handle. Back the other way. Brown open. That's lethal. Griner's return. Jefferson left that jumper short.
Forced that one a little bit.
Canada out to Samuelson for 3. Got it! Shot clock down to 6 already. Clarendon got to the rim. Here's Taurasi. Drives into the paint. Oh, sauce from Diana Taurasi inside. On the floor.
One of the really interesting things that she said to us this morning, Zaya Cook, we see you. Go ahead, rookie. That she said to us this morning was that in order to make things a little bit easier for Brittany Griner, she went in and put in some of the sets that were so successful 2 years ago. Diana Taurasi hits the 3 to make things easy using some of the sets that were so successful for her with the previous regime.
Mercury did make the playoffs last year, losing to the eventual champions, the Las Vegas Aces.
Doing what De'Aaron Mbembe is doing. Yeah, well, you're smart enough to know it's not.
Not me. Griner knocks down another midi. Just waiting for my complimentary subscription to come through. Did I say free? Oh, Clarendon for 3. And here's Samuelson, who was released by the squad and then re-signed just recently. Tough shot. And 1! Zaya Cook! Said there were times earlier during the offseason she didn't feel like working out, but she's giving work to the Sparks right now off glass. Sanzo was up by 3. Little step through move, and there's the leading scorer for the Sparks a season ago at over 18 per.
Just wanted to put her Mercury uniform back on by herself in the gym with some other people playing pickup.
Yeah, it really says a lot, Holly, about basketball being her. Here's Griner out high. Hands it back to Sutton on the drive. Converts with the left.
But how far she has come and to be able to perform the way she has so far in this game, absolutely remarkable.
A 3 good by Cook.
Tied with Diana Taurasi for most points in the game at 14. Hasn't missed a shot.
She biggest lead of the ball game right now for the Sparks, and it increases by three because of Shanae Ogwumike.
What's remarkable, too, L.A. was the worst three-point shooting team in the WNBA a season ago, averaged just over five per game. They already have six.
Wow, and another bucket by Ogwumike off glass. Under these unique circumstances. 5 seconds to go. Canada, little quick sit dribble, splash.
Who are overseas wrongfully detained, so certainly something that they are focusing on, even though she is back safe and sound.
Wow. Lexi Brown, that jumper still went.
And his team today has been exceptional on the offensive end, as we see another two from Neko Gubike. That coupled with shooting 47% from both field goal and three.
Jefferson on the empty corner two-person game with a reverse layup. Swing around, a little second side action. Clarendon on the drive, kicks it out. 10 on the shot clock. Nice feed inside. That's the sister act. Good screen by Griner to free Taurasi, but they turn it over. Bounce pass. Shug. Got it shook back at her. Wow. Neka hands it off to Clarendon. Neka flipped the screen back out to Shanae for three. Clean look. Butter. Straight butter.
It might be L.A. after this game and after the way they're playing. Actually, I think a lot of people are sleeping on Connecticut. I think they're going to be really good.
Well, Taurasi with a big-time block inside. Canada wide open look.
Well, it's been a lot of time in the last couple of years working on that midi. And
Shanae with the cleanup. Uses the screen. Great ball movement by Los Angeles. One more. Samuelson cashes out from the corner. Jefferson from deep, splash, got the three. Samuelson with the offensive rebound, interminable hustle.
This could be, ooh, nice.
Griner with her fourth block, that one on Hamby. Nice pocket pass, that jumper short, and another offensive rebound. Canada over Griner, too late. The giant killer. Jefferson off the screen. Jefferson knocks it down. 33 seconds to go in the quarter. Post up by Griner. Tough catch. Through the contact and one. Good defense by Canada. Was sitting on that spin move. Neko with the crossover in the open court and got it. Great to see those two together on the court. And boy, Griner wasn't impressed, scored over both of them that time.
Mark Davis has spared no expense. They have an unbelievable training room, cold tubs, force plates, movement systems. And I'm just telling you, it is cutting edge, scientific base.
After this game tonight, they are up 2-0 now. And I look back on the life of football legend and the late activist Jim Brown, one of the best to ever do it.
He probably didn't need to miss any time after she was born.
No. Three ball good. Phoenix with 22 field goals. That's the good news. The bad news is they've got 22 turnovers. Shug knocks down the three. A historic night punctuated by Brittany Griner's comeback to the court. In the big picture for Griner and the Mercury.